But I think the other one is the other issue, the opposite is also true. Mm. Historically, the men used to be called gatherers and hunters.
Gatherers
and hunters. Mm-hmm. Historically, men used to be called gatherers and hunters. And that doesn't mean they follow, it doesn't necessarily mean that traditional way of following, going to the bush and hunting. It's an analogy, if you study, that shows that the male gender went out. Mm. It's a very characteristic of the men, if you study. The male goes out, the male wants to be
even,
out.
Even today,
even
for
today.
Me, I find it very difficult to stay home.
Yes, that's common. Actually, if you talk to most women, one of the biggest struggles in a married couple is the ladies who say, he doesn't stay home, he's going. It's an innate nature of the male gender. He tends to go out. Now, this is the scenario today. A man spends a whole day confined in the four walls of an office. And from there, possibly because he's been there for 8 hours, he needs to go home. Not he wants, he needs to go home because there's another responsibility at home. And those who manage to get away with that, they want to go through social places. Now again, those social places are getting converted into different types of businesses. Most of them used to be social, you know, entities where people would sit together and they socialize with each other. So there isn't that luxury. And if they do, possibly they are drinking or something different, or church, it could be the opposite. So there is a competing time for the man. But the sad bit, which the men are under pressure to cope, is the fact that their traditional or innate lifestyle is now shifting to a more permanent office behavior. And that in itself is one of the drivers of what you call masculine crisis.
Mm-hmm. Now, when I think about the woman, I would imagine just the way the kind of current style of life has destabilized the man, the woman should have the same problem. Because I imagine a woman is by nature, there is a motherhood by nature inside the woman. So what happens to a woman who is forced to leave a child home and stay the whole day at work with that sense of wanting to breastfeed, to nurse a baby, to clean the baby and stuff? What does that do to the woman?
Many women are naturally mothers. Mm-hmm. The biggest struggle for a mother is to leave a baby, especially when they are toddlers. The worry of, will they be safe? Will the person you've left the baby with, like a household, take care? Is a child safe? And that's why many mothers or many families are now putting up cameras in the houses to secure the child. So no normal mother will just walk out. And I'm saying normal mothers, because not everybody is passionate about motherhood, but most mothers are really passionate about motherhood. So when you see a mother leave a toddler or a child of any age, just know there's another more pressing need to still support that child. And in most cases, there's economic needs that we're talking about. Because a child doesn't just require breastfeeding. What about when they grow, they would need nappies, they would require rent is needed in the house where they are living in, you know, the same house help to help. And there are this many other needs that the mother will need to also support the same child. So since they don't just come through breastfeeding alone, there are other social, political, economic, many needs that generally the same child will demand and require from the mother. Then the mother is forced to supplement. Mothers whose spouses, let's say wives or ladies who have another source of income, or spouses are willing or bringing in enough income at home, there are a number of ladies who opt to just be mothers and stay indoors. So the biggest worry for a mother is there enough to take care of the child? Women don't just go out to look for income, especially I'm talking of a mother who has a toddler, a mother who has young children. They are going out there because they need to look for money to be able to support these children in all ways, social, food, you know, housing, education. That's really, those are some of the drives.